Hey guys, this is my first entry into the Warts and All Facebook group's 1944 group build, the year of 75th anniversaries. This is my Zhitomir Berdichev diorama. It's based on a propaganda photo that was taken by the Soviets in the area, I'm guessing after the battle. Probably not too long after the battle, that's my guess anyway. They had either set this tiger on fire or set up a bucket of oily rags and set that on fire, or threw a smoke grenade inside the tiger or something like that to cause some smoke to billow out of it. And then they parked a T-34 with a bunch of infantry fellows in white camo smocks sitting all over it on the side of the road and took an action shot. Then they took another photo a little while later that obscures the tiger in the background with a second T-34 parked further on the road with even more guys riding on it. So, but I built mine based on, I don't know if you can see it, that photo there. That's the photo that I built it on. Tried to capture it as relatively close as I could. Anyway, the smoke was probably the most difficult thing to do. The next most was trying to repaint the tiger. The tiger is a pain in the butt. The tiger is actually a kit that I built several years ago. It was really my first attempt at super detailing, and a lot of work went into it. So I wanted to reuse it if I could, rather than pitch it in the garbage. So I stripped it of all of its parts that weren't supposed to be there for this build anyway, and then I put some new tracks on it and repainted the whole thing from scratch, basically reprimed it, repainted it, new paint job, new camouflage, all that stuff, and then I added some burns to it, drilled a hole in the side of it for the knockout blow, because I'm assuming the tank was knocked out somehow. So I put that in there. You can't see it anyway because it's obscured by the smoke. The smoke was the other thing that was difficult. That's all cotton batting that I teased apart, and that took a really long time, and probably five or six attempts to try and get it so that I liked the way it looked. And like is a strong word that I'm using, because I'm not going to get it any better. It's close to the opaqueness that appears in the photograph, in some degrees. And I couldn't pile it up any higher because I have a very thin frame that's holding it together, and then hairspray that's holding it together to give it rigidity. But it'll only bear so much weight before it starts to collapse in on itself. And cotton batting's not that strong, right? So I can't pile it up high enough in order to make the cloud thick enough that I'd like it. The hairspray is holding it together quite well, actually. And then I sprayed it with white glue as well, thinned white glue. But that seemed to clump quite a lot, so that was an earlier attempt that ended up getting, that's not on here now. I had to remove that. The hairspray was the better fixer for it. I also flowed thin white glue into it to build like a rigid structure inside, and fix it to the base that way so it doesn't move. And then I had to paint it because it was just stark white and it didn't look right. The first couple of pictures I took of it unpainted, it looked stupid. So I decided, well, let's try and paint this and hopefully it won't blow away. It didn't. I was surprised. It stayed quite firmly attached. It didn't even wiggle, really. I was very impressed. Stronger than I thought. So I sprayed it with some gray spray paint, which wasn't very easy to do because I didn't want to spray any on the tank itself, so it took quite a bit of care to make sure I didn't overspray anything. But it turned out better than I thought anyway, so it's still not as good as I would like it to be. The smoke looks like it's sitting on the ground rather than wisping through the ground. The smoke doesn't sit on the ground. It kind of just sort of envelops it. So it looks like it's sitting on the ground. So I don't think there's any way for me to get around that other than having real smoke. But since it's a static model, it's, I think, the closest that I, with my skills and talents and know-how, could do. So... So this is pretty much that. Anyway, the figures were another bit of a challenge because the figure sets that I bought, one was a trumpeter and one was the mini art. Both trumpeter and mini art are not the best figure makers when it comes to kits. Trumpeter being least of the two, the trumpeter figures were really dodgy. Very poor flat blah detail. The accuracy of it was somewhat questionable. I'm not really sold on the uniforms that they're wearing. The mini art ones were better, but they're very flashy, chunky detail, and a lot of work needed to be done to get them to work. A lot of filling. I think they look okay for what they are anyway. They somewhat resemble the pose of the fellows in the photo. There's the fellows in the photo there. And there's the fellows in the T-34. They're close. I couldn't get them exactly posed correctly. I mean, I reposed, five of them? Or six of them, I think it was. So that they were close to the positions, but there were quite a few of them. They're just way too out of line, and I couldn't get them to do it. So, but for the most part, though, they come close enough, I think, that if you had seen the photograph before, you would go, hey, I know that photograph. At least that's my hope. So that's that, I guess. I really don't have much else to say about the diorama. It was a very simple diorama. It's probably the most simple one I've ever done. But it had some interesting challenges. So even the simplest of things can be sometimes the most challenging. So it's the most amount that I've ever remodeled figures. This many, anyway. Reposing figures isn't that difficult. You just cut chunks out of the joins where their elbows are, where their knees are, and then take a little bit of heat and add it to what's left of the the plastic, and bend it gently. And then glue and fill, basically. It's not that difficult to do. So some of them were actually quite a lot reposed. This fellow here, and this fella here, the two in the front, they were very much reposed. And there's another guy, too. Which guy was it? Oh, I didn't use him. There's one guy I didn't even use at all. He was lying on the ground. I didn't bother using him. But I ended up reposing his legs and stuff. But I ended up not liking his pose. I couldn't find a spot for him on the tank anyway, where he would fit comfortably. So I ended up not using him. But, these two guys here, and actually this guy here, I redid his foot, and I think I redid one of his arms, this fellow here. So these three fellows here are the most reposed. I rebent their knees, and I rebent one guy's elbow and his ankle, so in order for him to fit. So anyway, I think that's it. Yeah. Still got plenty more to build for the rest of the group build. I have another one on the go right now. And I had an idea of doing a third one for the first part. I was going to do something else with this diorama idea, but I might end up using it for a third entry. I'm not sure. It's a very inspiring group build, so it's easy to build for it. There's so many different things you can pick from. The first part is harder because there's the first part of 1944 was like the calm before the storm, so to speak. Because after June the 6th, everything ramped up and there was a lot of action going on. There were some big battles going on prior to that, but they were localized. They weren't spread all across the entire continental Europe like they were after June the 6th. So you have a narrower focus for the first half. So I thought that was interesting. It's like a deep breath was taken for the first part of 1944, and then it was all let out after June the 6th. It's kind of interesting. So, but anyway, so I have possibly another one that I might do. But it might be, see, it's an Anzio diorama, so it's could very easily be stuck in there. So anyway, doesn't matter. So that's what this thing looks like now. I mean, it's, I'll give it a spin around so you can see what it looks like. Move it like so, so you can see more of it. Anyway, it's mostly meant to be seen from one direction because it mimics the photograph from that one direction. But that doesn't mean you can't spin it around and look at it from other directions. I mean, it's taken from a photograph, so like all the spaces in between that you can't see in the photograph still exist, so I had to model them, but there's nothing in those areas, so like there's nothing to fill it with. So the void that's here is natural void, and the void that's back here is a natural void, and the void that's back here is a natural void, and the void here is a natural void. There are, they all appear in the photograph. The focus for the photographer was the tiger in the T-34. So anyway, I think that's it. That's all I got. Slideshow will be very short. There's not much to take pictures of here. So that's it. Short, sweet. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now. Shrubbery! You gotta love it when Mother Nature just drops off a piece of shrubbery on your front step. Didn't have to order it. It just was sitting there. Gotta love it. Fell off the tree just outside my door. Landed there. Perfectly good pair of pants. No more. I've got free shrubbery. Gotta like it.